Hello friends, on popular demand, I am starting a new series of Azure Fundamental AZ900 full course. In this series, what I'll do is I will cover all the objectives of AZ900 certification exam, and I will teach you all the concepts which is needed for clearing your AZ900 Fundamental certification exam. So I promise you, I'll keep this course as short and as relevant as possible so that you can learn and you can complete your certification in the shortest possible time. And please do keep watch this video at the end, because at the end I will share the practice questions for all of these objectives which we are covering in this video. So in the format will be, in every video you will see the concept, and at the end of the session you will have a practice question to cover up all those concepts that we have learned. So I am Deepak Goyal, having 12 years of experience in IT, and I am a certified Azure Technical Architect. I will teach you through this AZ900 certification. So don't waste time, let's begin the video. In episode 1, we will cover what is cloud computing, and we also see what are the different advantages of cloud computing, like high availability, elasticity, scalability, and many more. So let's discuss first what is cloud computing. Cloud computing is something which provide you services over the internet. Let's say, for example, you want to have in storage services. You want to store some of your data, and for that purpose, what generally you do is you buy a hard disk, or you may buy a pen drive or a USB drive. But using cloud computing, what you can do is you can get this storage space over the internet or over the cloud, and you copy your data from your machine to the cloud. So you don't need to buy anything, and you can get available all these services over the internet and easily. Similarly, you can have a compute services where, for example, you want to have a machine of which is of having some RAM and processor. So rather than buying a physical, you can get that machine over the internet using the cloud. Similarly, cloud also provide networking services, analytics services, AI services, machine learning services, and many more. Let's discuss what is the advantages of the cloud computing. The first one is high availability. What high availability says is you have a very small or almost zero downtime. Why it is possible in the cloud computing? Because your cloud providers have a multiple data centers and their backup ready. So let's say if you take a one server from a cloud, and if some problems happens up on that data center, automatically your server will transfer its load to the another server in another data center, and you get almost a zero downtime. And all this happens up behind the scene. So that's how you can achieve a high availability in the cloud computing. Next one is in scalability. Scalability basically is of two types. One is vertical scalability, another one is in horizontal scalability. In vertical scalability, you increase the resources within a machine or within a server. For example, if you increase the size of a server, for example, from a 32 GB RAM to, let's say, 64 gigs of RAM, or from a 4 processor to like an 8 processor, so you are increasing it vertically. This is called as vertical scaling, which is scale up or scale down. Similarly, sometimes you put in cloud, you also can do a horizontal scaling. In horizontal scaling, let's say you want to have a multiple copy of a same server machines. So you have a, instead of one server machine, you want a similarly 2, 4, or 8 or 10 server machine. So That is called as horizontal scaling. It is also called as scale out or scale in. Next one is elasticity. So elasticity is somewhat of your scalability features only. In scalability, you do scale up or down, or scale out or scale in. In elasticity, it is like a rubber. You want to stretch here in the horizontal, or you want to stretch up and down. It's up to you. And the most important thing in elasticity is it do a auto scaling. For example, you running a website of, say, a news website, okay? And its server, suddenly some pandemic news came up. So suddenly there's a lot of traffic will come up on your server. So to handle this, if you have set an auto scaling feature, it will automatically scale up or scale out your server to handle that new traffic which is coming in. And once this traffic gets settled out and it gets reduced, it will automatically reduce down your server machines or server resources. So it will automatically scale in or it will do scale down. So that's the automatic happens up through the elasticity feature. Next one is agility. Agility is something which helps you to start your servers, start your applications, or deploy your applications very easily and fastly. All this compute and storage power are available just a click away in the cloud. You just click it and you get the storage, you get the servers of any size, whatever you want. So setting up the resources or getting the resources is very fast. That's why it helps you to manage and deploy your applications and your workload in a very agile way. The next one is geo distribution. Edge cloud is located across the world. So they have their data centers in multiple continents and multiple geographical locations. So assume that you have a lot of your customers or clients who access your application from a US location. So what you can do is you can have one server in the US location. Similarly, you have a couple of your clients access it from the Asia region. So you can have one server which is in the Asia. So you can have a server available near to your audience. This will helps you to reduce down the latency and helps to improve the performance. This can be achieved using the feature of geo distribution by the cloud computing. The last one is the disaster recovery. And as the geo distribution says that you can have your servers, your data located at the different geographical location. So you know that you have an advantage of distributing or mitigating your risk to a one location. If, for example, if some flood or some natural calamity happens up in a US region, you know that your data is backed at a different geography like Asia or somewhere else, which is very far away from your stored location. So that helps you to recover from a disaster in a much easier way. So by this, we have reached to the last section of our video, that is the practice question for all the knowledge that we have learned in this session. So what you can do is you can log on to this website. Here you will find all the questions which is relevant for the objective that we have covered in this session. So practice up and make sure that you can answer all those concepts. So by this, we reach to the end of this video. If you like the video, please press the like icon and do subscribe to the channel. In the next video, I'll come up with the next objectives needed for our AZ 900 certification exam. So till then, goodbye, keep learning.